Hallo Friends. Welcome to Creative Medicine. In this lecture, we will learn about. Hello Friends, let us now learn some important points about hepatorenal syndrome. So in the hepatorenal syndrome, it is defined as a state of in patients with severe liver disease. First, there is severe liver disease. In severe liver disease, there occurs decrease in GFR. First, there is severe liver disease and then there is decreased GFR. That means it is a state of functional renal failure occurs. Okay, that is the thing. But if you see histologically, if you do renal biopsy, the kidneys will be found to be completely normal. So here the problem is not in the kidneys but in the liver disease, thus leading to decreased GFR. So this syndrome will recover after successful liver transplantation. After successful liver transplantation, the patient will recover. Okay, the main problem here, pathology, if you see, it is mainly due to the there occurs because of systemic okay there occurs intense renal vasoconstriction. The blood vessels which are supplying the liver are vasoconstricted with coexistent systemic vasodilatation. There occurs systemic vasodilatation also. Okay, so this is the pathogenesis of hepatorenal syndrome. Then if you see the diagnosis of hepatorenal syndrome, so we have the diagnostic criteria. This diagnostic criteria is very important for hepatorenal syndrome. So if you see, first we have major criteria. Major criteria include there will be decreased glomerular filtration rate. Indicated one, decreased glomerular filtration rate indicated by serum creatinine which is more than 1.5 milligram per deciliter or 24 hour creatinine clearance or 24 hour creatinine clearance will be less than 40 ml per minute. That is first criteria. Second criteria, there will be absence of shock, ongoing bacterial infections. There will be absence of shock, ongoing bacterial infections and fluid losses will also be not there. And there will be absence of shock, ongoing bacterial infections and fluid losses. And the patient is current on treatment with nephrotoxic drugs, or the patient is currently in treatment with nephrotoxic drugs. If the patient has absence of shock, or if the patient has ongoing bacterial infection or fluid losses or current treatment with nephrotoxic drugs, all these are major criteria number two. Then if the patient has no improvement in renal function, if the patient has no improvement in renal function or decrease in serum creatinine, or if the patient has decrease in serum creatinine to 1.5 milligrams per deciliter, or if there is increase in creatinine clearance is increased to 40 milliliters per minute after. If there is decrease in serum creatinine to 1.5 milligram per liter, or increase in serum creatinine, increase in creatinine clearance to 40 ml per liter after diuretic withdrawal. Okay, and if there is expansion of plasma volume has occurred, or if there is expansion of plasma volume has occurred with 1.5 liters of plasma expander, that means overall there is deterioration of liver renal function. You can say all of this, there is deterioration of renal function. Then if you see the fourth criteria, Fourth criteria is if the patient has proteinuria with less than 500 milligram per deciliter and there is no ultrasonographic evidence, or if there is no ultrasonographic evidence of obstructive uropathy or parenchymal renal disease. So all these parenchymal renal disease, all these are the criteria, that is major criteria. Now if you see the additional criteria, in the additional criteria you will see that there will be urine volume. If the urine volume is less than 500 milliliter per day, second, if the urine sodium is less than 10 milli equivalent per day, per liter, then if the third, if urine osmolality is greater than plasma osmolality, if urine osmolality is greater than plasma osmolality, then fourth, if urine RBC is less than 50 per high power field, if urine osmolality is less than 50 per high power field, then fifth, if serum sodium concentration is less than 130 milli equivalent per liter. Okay, so all these are the additional criteria for hepatorenal syndrome. So this is about hepatorenal syndrome. Thank you for watching.
Thank you, and thank you for watching.